Calf diarrhea is a common problem and a major cause of economic loss to dairy and beef producers around the world.
In the report of the 2007 National Animal Health Monitoring System, 57% of deaths among unweaned U.S. dairy calves were attributed to diarrhea. The loss of water and electrolytes during an event of diarrhea can lead to severe dehydration. Additionally, it can impair the calf's ability to digest nutrients. The more we study diarrhea, the more we understand that it's complex and hard to prevent. But regardless of its cause, reducing the dehydration associated with diarrhea is crucial.
As a producer, proper management of diarrhea is critical. It can be challenging to determine if the diarrhea and dehydration your calves are experiencing could be life-threatening, when you should seek veterinary advice, and what treatments should be given. In this three-part series, I review the common causes of calf diarrhea, diarrhea prevention, and recommended steps to address diarrhea when it occurs.
The major types of diarrhea can be classified as secretory, malabsorptive, and inflammatory. Multiple pathogens are associated with calf diarrhea. Bacteria, like Salmonella and E. coli, viruses, like bovine rotavirus and coronavirus, as well as internal parasites, like coccidia. The prevalence of pathogens can vary by geography, herd size, and farm management practice. The infectious agent may produce toxins in the lumen of the gut, can also directly damage the lining of the gut, or both. Regardless of the mechanism, formation of diarrhea draws large amount of body fluid into the intestinal lumen. As a result, the calf quickly becomes dehydrated, electrolytes are unbalanced, and energy reserves become depleted. Because diarrhea is symptomatic of underlying gastrointestinal illness, the sooner that fluid loss can be limited, the sooner the calf is likely to recover. Relieving the physiological stress of dehydration from diarrhea allows the calf to deploy more of its energy reserves towards fighting underlying infections.
Thank you for watching. In the second video of this series, I review important steps you can take to prevent diarrhea and severe dehydration on your farm.